Hey, hey.
Today's video will be about these IEMs, which I got for only 20 euros, which pretty much equals $20. But before I start to review them, let's recap how I got here. So for a few years, these were my main headphones, the Beyerdynamic DT990 Pro. But thanks to Fresh, I recently switched from the DT990 to the Moontrop Area as my headphones. And the more I used them, the more I became interested in IEMs in general, the more videos about IEMs I watched, until I found this video from the audiophile YouTuber Quinical, aka the IEM guy, and I couldn't wait to try them out. Don't worry, I will put his video in the end card. But before we hop into the unboxing, let's figure out what makes a headphone a good gaming headphone. So many consumer headphones for music are often pretty bass heavy, which is not what you want as a gamer. When it comes to competitive FPS gaming, the most important thing is that you hear the steps of your enemies. These are often more in the mids and in the heights and not in the bass. At least if your enemy is not Brimstone. So often with these bass heavy headphones, you hear the shooting pretty loud, but you can't really hear the steps. So what we want as a gamer is a more balanced headphone, at least in my opinion. And this is also what an audiophile wants from a headphone. So I would consider, if an audiophile say it's a good headphone, it's also a good gaming headphone. At least that's my opinion. We can discuss about it if you have another opinion. Write it in the comments. The only scenario where you might prefer a bass heavy headphone for gaming is when you're in a solo player game and you want a more immersive feeling. Then bass heavy is probably the way to go. But for competitive, I wouldn't take bass heavy. So with this said, let's hop into the unboxing. So first of all, bonus points for Vive on the package. One of the reasons why I love Moontrop, but don't tell my wife, please. Let's start with the unboxing. First of all, we have a little carrying bag, which I think is pretty neat for this price point. Then we have those rubber things to route the cable behind the ear. A pair of Moontrop's spring ear tips in three sides. A manual in Japanese and in English. Show. And last but not least, the earphones with a little zip tie. Let's take a closer look. I've ordered the version with the mic because I was curious if you can use them as a headset. So technically you can. And they even sound a bit better than I'd expected it. The cable is nothing special. It feels pretty rubbery, but it's doing its job. And keep in mind that the cable is not detachable. But you can't get everything for 20 bucks. You wear them with the cable coming out on top, and then you put it behind your ears. The Chews are very comfortable IEMs, at least in my ears. The build quality is surprisingly decent. They are made out of metal, as you can hear. And I really like the Moontrop spring tips. So let's talk about the sound. There's actually not much I can say about the sounds that hasn't already been said. For this price point, these are really balanced IEMs. And as I expected, they are very great for gaming, at least in Valorant. Compared to the Aria, I felt that the Chews were much clearer in the heights, and in Valorant it was way easier for me to hear the steps with the Chews. I was curious if what I heard correlates with some frequency response measurements, so I looked them both up on Quinical's homepage, and it seems like my ears didn't lie to me. You will see what I mean when I put the graphs together. As you can see, the areas are slowly dropping in the heights compared to the two. But I didn't only use the twos for gaming, I also listened to a lot of music with them. For example, when I was walking with the dogs, I often put them in my ears, and I really like them. To sum it up, these are great IEMs for gaming, and I would prefer them over the Moondrop Aria, at least when it comes to the sound. But if a detachable cable and the overall IEM aesthetic is also important for you, there's another pair of cheap IEMs, the Moondrop SSP. They come at 40 bucks, and in my opinion, they are also better than the Aria. But hold on before you buy them, because they also have a sibling, the Moondrop SSR, which are known for their lack of bass but strong heights. And I really want to hear how this feels in game. But I don't have them here yet. I've ordered them. I want to make a video about these two. So don't forget to leave a sub if you don't want to miss up on this. This was my video about the Moondrop 2. I hope you liked it. As promised, I will put a link to Krinical's video about them somewhere here in the end card. And I wish you a wonderful day, and bye.